time of his life for
jealousy is evil. And if you're a jealous person, you can never move forward. If you're a jealous person, you can never go higher in life. If you're a jealous person, you have the spirit of jealousy and you're not ready to curtail it. You are not ready to bring it to subjection to the spirit of God and allow the spirit of God to rule over your heart and your mind, then you will live beyond the, you will be at that level where you can never rise. Check it out. A lot of people who are envious of other people, they never rise above where they are. And that is why they would do anything to just slay that person or to destroy that person or to kill that person. So be very careful, because there are
consequences. I always tell people, don't be envious of people, especially when you don't know their story. Don't be jealous of people when you don't know how much hard work or how much they've put in, you know, to achieve the things that they have, or how much work they've put in to be successful in life, because success has a price to be paid, and one of the prizes includes hard work. There are people who have worked so hard in their lives, you know, to obtain those things that are in their possession. So when you are jealous of that person, you are envious of that person, and you're like, oh, why should it be he or she that is in possession of this thing, why not myself, then you are not doing yourself any good, because there are people who had to, you know, go through so much in life, you know, to be where they are, to climb to that level where they are. There are people who, you see what they are doing, progressing, you see them excelling in a particular area of their lives, and you are envious of them without knowing, you know, how much hard work they put in to.
Hello everyone, how are you all doing? I hope everyone is doing well, and I hope you are living above the circumstances of life and you are fulfilling your purpose. Try as much as possible to fulfill that purpose for which you were born, that purpose for which God created you. And remember that God has deposited so much on the inside of you. It doesn't matter what gifts you have, it doesn't matter what talents, it doesn't matter what purpose you have. What matters is that you fulfill it before you exit this life, hallelujah, or before we see our Lord and Savior Jesus. Make sure you fulfill this purpose. Make sure you use your talents to the glory of God, and make sure above all you keep it. So it's your girl Claire, and I remain your girl Claire. Before I go into what I have to say today, I just want to say thank you to every one of you, my subscribers, my viewers, members of this channel, and everyone who has been here to view one of my videos or some of my videos. A big thank you to you all. I appreciate you all, and I don't take it for granted. God bless you all. So today I am actually out here to talk about the spirit of jealousy. Why am I talking about the spirit of jealousy? Because when I look around me, I see a whole lot of things going on. And oftentimes when you see such things going on all around the globe, you can't help but say, this is all about envy, this is all about jealousy. People are killing each other because of envy and jealousy. People are talking other people down because of the spirit of envy and jealousy. People are destroying other people's image just because of the spirit of envy and jealousy. So, and I am not amazed, because this, you know, happened back in the days of old. And an example is Cain killing his own brother Abel. We see how, because of the spirit of envy and because of jealousy, he ended up killing his brother, because the sacrifice of Abel was accepted by God, instead of him to look for a better way, you know, to try to, you know, reach out to God and be able to, you know, get the attention of God, which his brother Abel was able to do. But he didn't do that. Rather, he felt, oh, Abel, my brother, is the problem. So oftentimes in life, we always feel, oh, this person is my problem, because of that, let me get rid of him or her, or do something, you know, bad to him or her out of envy and out of jealousy. So then we also see the story of Joseph, how he ended up being sold into Egypt, how he ended up in prison, all because of the spirit of envy and jealousy.
And then we look at King David, you know, how King Saul sought after his life just because people praised David more than him. So it was like, oh, how could they praise King David? You know, how could they praise him better than him? You know, it's like the people were insinuating that David was better. So because of that, he went after David's life. So it's happening even in our time. We also see Daniel. Daniel was also put in the lion's den because of what he had, an excellent spirit. So oftentimes people who are jealous of other people, they do that because they feel this person is better off than me. This person has something, you know, in his or her possession, or this person has a quality that I don't have. And because of that, you know, they go like, oh, why should it be him? Why should it be her? Why not myself? And I feel it's all because of ego, because people who are envious and jealous of other people, it's all about them. If you look at it very well, it's always, why is it that he or she has this, or he or she's in possession of this and that, why not myself? It's always about them. So I think the spirit of jealousy is a quality that's, or something that every other person can have, you know, but the way we deal with it and the way we are able to put it under control, you know, be able to bring it under subjection, you know, is what really matters. So if an individual is able to control that spirit, then you won't be jealous or envious of people because you feel they are better off than you, or you won't be bitter about people or angry with people because you feel, oh, they're excelling, they are climbing higher, or they are doing better than you, or have those things that you don't have. So be very careful how you are jealous of people or how you envy people, because you don't know what they passed through or what they've been through to be where they are in life. And you don't even know how many hurdles they had to jump through to get to where you see the glory, where you see, oh, you know, everything around them is looking blissful. You know, people are jealous of people because they feel, oh, he's in possession of a car while I don't have one. Do you know how long it took that person to save money to buy that car? Do you know how long it took that woman or that man to build up his marriage that you were jealous of? Do you know how long it took that person, you know, to that house, that beautiful house that you see? Do you know how long that man, that woman worked, you know, to buy that house or to build that kind of house? Be very careful how you're jealous of people, because at the end of the day, jealousy will make you to do something outside the will of God for your life. Jealousy and envy is worse than cancer. I always say to people, you might think, oh, I'm healthy because, you know, I'm not sick, but jealousy, envy is worse than cancer, because anyone who has it is not well. Anyone who has the spirit is not doing well. So it's either you learn to bring it under control or bring it under subjection to the will of God and to the spirit of God. Rebuke that spirit anytime it comes up. Refuse to see that this person is better than you, because I always tell people, I don't see anyone better than me. I don't see people that way. I don't see people like, oh, this person is doing better than me. I learned that myself, because when you see people doing better than you, then there's this tendency for you to be jealous of them or envious of them. But when you see you in your own, you know, eyes as unique, because when you see yourself as unique, when you see yourself as the one that God has made you to be, you will be contented with what you have. You'll be contented with yourself. You'll be contented with whatever is in your possession. So the problem with a lot of people is that they don't appreciate whatever it is that they have in their possession. They are not satisfied with. God has blessed every person with the potential. God has deposited in everyone their own gifts, their own talent. But if you are not ready to discover yours, and you are envious of other people because they are using what God has blessed them with to the glory of God, then you have a problem. So being jealous of people because they are doing well, because you see the glory around them without knowing their story. If you look at every individual that is successful in life, there's a story to it. There is always a story to their successful life. because people work hard to get to where they are. A lot of people work hard to get that thing that you see right now that is in their possession, that you are thinking, oh, they have it all. They have it all. Do you know the sleepless nights? Do you know how much hard work they had to put in to get that thing, or to, you know, be in possession of that thing? Be careful how you envy people. Be careful how you're jealous of people, because it has a consequence. You know, there's always consequences for being jealous of people, because when you're jealous of someone, the devil will manipulate your mind to that point where you will do anything to destroy that individual. Why? Because the devil will manipulate your heart, manipulate your mind, manipulate your spirit to see that this person, oh, is doing well better than you. And you are like, oh, why should it be him? Why not me? And that will make you go after that person. Remember in the Bible, it happens to people. So don't think, oh, because, you know, I am just perfect, so I can't, you know, get to that level. It's possible to be jealous of someone without knowing you are even jealous of them. Because jealousy will even make you to hate someone who has done you no wrong for no reason. There are people who don't just want to see other people with their eyes, not because that person did anything wrong to them, but because of the spirit of jealousy. So be very careful. I have had people say, oh, God is a why shouldn't I be jealous? After all, God too is a jealous God. God is a jealous God, but in a protective way. God is not jealous to do evil, but God is jealous to do good. So if you are going to be jealous of anyone or envious of anyone, let it be that you are being motivated by what is going on in their lives. Let that jealousy be that of motivation. Be motivated by the fact that, oh, this person is excelling. This person is successful. This person is doing well. So I want to know the secret so that I can also do well. But if you are like, oh, he or she is doing well, let me run him or her down. Begin to say things that will make people to con against him or her, or let me just do whatever I need to do, or even go diabolic, you know, to make sure he or she doesn't excel. There are consequences. Be careful, because Cain did the same thing, and at the end of the day, there was a penalty for it. There's always a penalty for anything that is evil. So if that spirit of jealousy is not brought into subjection, like I said, you know, or curtailed, then it can lead to someone killing someone. Sorry, it's a little bit loud here, but it's all good. So be careful how you are jealous of people, because you don't know their story. You don't know the hurdles they had to jump. You don't know how many times they were down in the valley before God raised them up to that place where you can see them up on the mountain. You don't know their lowest point, what they had to go through when they were at their lowest point. You don't know how many times they cried out their eyes when they were in their lowest point, and God had to raise them, you know, to the level where you are now seeing them, you know, shining and looking good, and everything around them is looking blissful. So don't be jealous of anyone, because being jealous of people will make you do that which is not right in the sight of God. Be very careful. In the scriptures, like I said, you see, you know, people who, because of what God placed in them, people were jealous of them and even went after their lives. So that spirit of jealousy can make you go after somebody's life just because you feel, oh, they're in possession of what you don't have. Remember that God has placed in you too something. Rejoice with those who are rejoicing. When someone is doing well, rejoice with them. Be happy for them. Find out the secret and begin to walk in the light of, you know, whatever it is that has placed them in that place where they are. And God will uplift you. And don't, because of envy and jealousy, begin to talk about them. Oh, maybe that person just bought a new car out of jealousy because you don't have a car. Oh, maybe he even stole it. Oh, maybe he robbed the bank to buy the car. Whatever it is, don't even be envious of anybody. If they bought a car, oh, good, well, good. If they built a house, oh, well, good, to the glory of God. Like I said, behind every successful person, there's a story. There is a story. You don't know what they went through to get to that level where they are. So the spirit of jealousy is a bad spirit. Don't be envious of anybody. Jealousy will make you want to talk somebody down or ring him or her. Don't tell me because I've never stabbed somebody, I've never shot somebody because of that, you know, all is good. You can kill somebody with your words. Words are very powerful. words are very powerful. With words, you can build, and with words, you can destroy. So be careful what you say about people just because you feel God is raising them up, or because you feel everything in their lives is going the way, you know, the way it should, or you're seeing everything about their lives perfect. You don't know what they are going through on the inside. You don't know what they are suffering on the inside. Don't see people's marriages and think, oh, because, you know, it looks blissful on the outside. You don't know what they are going through on the inside. Don't see people, you know, doing well and just think, oh, it is well with them. You don't know what they go through, you know, or what they went through to get to that place of glory. God bless you. And I hope, you know, you are blessed. Oh, it's so loud today. So, and I hope that you've been blessed by these words. I just want us to know that there are consequences of being jealous. Don't be a jealous individual. Rejoice with people when they are doing well. Celebrate people when they are doing well. Celebrate people when they are, you know, excelling in life. And God will bring you to that point of glorification soon. God bless you. And I love you. And I'm still your dear. Claire. Bye-bye.